Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Jan Sewing Solutions for these quick tutorials that's going to enhance our learning techniques and methods that we're going to apply in making these very fast and quick outfits out of remnants for children. Okay, so the first thing that I've done is the pieces. I've combined three sets of pieces. So what we're going to do is we're going to do three tutorials at a time. And the first three that we're going to do is going to be a very simple dress in this cotton. We're going to start off with cotton because obviously it's the easiest and the simplest to sew. So you're not going to have any problems in stitching this. Now, this particular cotton is one that has been it's one of those embroidered cottons that has had how on duvets you have the blocks, and these have been machine done where the distance of all the quilting sort of boxes is absolutely identical and symmetric. This is generally done on pre-done fabric, although if you wanted to apply the method, you can do it yourself. We haven't got time, so we're using a pre-done one. This is just a leftover piece from fabric that used to be quite commonly available once upon a time. So actually, before even going on to doing this, believe it or not, I generally make a lot of outfits for Inaya. Today I don't have an outfit of hers, and I'm just wondering if I've got any of her measurements from previous times. Okay, so if you were going to take measurements, I'm going to just go on to explain before I go on to the cutting. If you were going to take the measurements, you want the measurements of the child. First of all, take the tape measure and measure from the top of the shoulder, which is top of the shoulder, to the length that you require. This could be ankle, knee length, thigh length, or ankle length, or whatever. Generally, the best size for a child would be knee length, because it stops them from tripping over and stuff, and it keeps them covered and keeps them comfortable. So if you're going to, first of all, you need to take the full length, so from the shoulder to the knee, and then you want to take from the shoulder to the waist length, and that's generally the part where the thinnest part of the waistline is. On an adult, this is generally between 15, 16, 16 and a half, 17, 14 and a half, sort of length. On a child, obviously that will be a lot shorter. Then you want across the shoulders, so from the one point of the shoulder blade to the other, the length for the sleeve. I would recommend making full sleeves for children for a number of reasons. Children do not like wearing cardigans and so on, and personally I don't like Inaya in short sleeves because it just makes her arms feel cold. So I would like to make it in sort of full length sleeves. Then you want to sort of take a measurement across the chest area. Although children don't have, there isn't really much of a difference between the chest and the waist. Okay, most of these dresses that we're going to make, the hip area or the the bottom area is going to be just a little bit wide, but these are going to be flary sort of frocks, so it really won't really require that measurement, although for the sake of it I would just take that measurement also. Then you just want the measurement for the churidar or the salwar, or and that would be from the waist down to the ankles. The other measurement, depending on the neck size, take the measurement of the depth of the neck. Often we have a problem that we make the necklines too large, where the under waist of the garment is visible, or we make the necks too small and the child cannot get it over their head. Most of the time with children's dresses, you either need to put hooks or you need to put buttons on, so that they're easy to take on and off. Okay, children don't actually require a lot of fitting and so on. They're generally loose fitting garments and they're very, very easy to sew. They're the least critical wearers. they're the customers who don't actually criticize. They love what you do for them. So no matter what you stitch and what you sew, as long as the people who see them wearing them praise them, then the child will love that garment and will want to wear it again and again. Like with all of us, if somebody criticizes the garment, that, oh, what you're wearing, you look like this, and we often have the habit of doing that, then that will put the child off wearing that particular garment, and it will also devastate the person who made that garment. So for anyone who's watching that has a habit of criticizing, then do change your habit, because change that negative criticism to positive feedback, and inshallah, even if there are mistakes in what the person has done, then subtly point those mistakes out. Don't be abrupt with pointing those mistakes out, that, oh, what have you done? What, you know, you've ruined it, you've made this, you made her look like a clown, and those kind of that kind of criticism put in that kind of sense, in that kind of context, actually really guts a person, if you know what I mean. You know, there's nothing worse than criticism that is put so abruptly that it hurts you. And that is a very bad habit that many of us have. Fair enough, criticism is brilliant when it's done in a subtle way. Because without criticism, we cannot actually look forward and become a better person. But it has to be put in its right context. And it's often the criticism that gets you really down is in the manner that that criticism is put. I often get that, and I often rebuke it as well. Because once you are trying to help people and you are doing a service, I don't have to be here. I don't have to do any of this. I choose to do this because I think it's beneficial for my viewers to watch and to learn. But then to get criticized for it, you know, we always get the negative. It always makes me wonder, you know, when you get a thumbs down on a video, why has that person given it a thumbs down? Is it just out of habit, or is it something that they've found? If they've found something wrong and they've thumbed that video down, then what they need to do is they've actually need to put down what is the reason why you're putting that video down. You know, in what way has it not benefited you? And if it hasn't benefited you, then you know, you can actually refrain from watching it. Why go and criticize something without actually pointing out to the person what it is that you are so some people just have a habit of the thumb, right? Just go and click the dislike. If you're going to dislike it, then give reason why you're disliking that particular thing. And maybe that gives the person who's making that video the opportunity to amend their mistake and make it better for the next time. Anyway, we live and we learn. I don't mind. Criticism is all very good. And, if you are getting criticized, then try and take it positively. Learn from that mistake. Try and perfect it so that next time you don't give that person the room to criticize you. And prove to them that you're the better person. So inshallah, that's what we're going to do. We're going to prove that we're better people and we can take criticism, and we're going to come out shining. And inshallah, anyone who's learning will hopefully shine out too. So we were going to start with number one outfit, but I need to go and find a few measurements. I've explained the measurements. Take down those measurements and then join me in the next clip, where we're going to apply the technique into practice.